ask yourself, would you be equally anxious to buy a flat if you didn't have that flesh in your life? Consumption promotes further consumption. So if you are already addicted to one form of consumption, know that many other forms of consumption are just waiting to leap into your life. You cannot avoid them. If today you are buying pretty sandals for your beloved, for sure tomorrow you would be buying milk bottles for the infant. Consumption begets more consumption. One kind of consumption leads to another kind of consumption. Material is material and all flesh is material. If today you are spending on your wedding, tomorrow is it not certain that you would be spending on childbirth? In fact, people are wise. Once they have a man or woman in life, they actually know that many other little persons are now going to enter life. So they plan in advance. Let's have a house that has two spare rooms. Chunnu and Munnu are already there. They are just invisible. They are right now in their subtle forms. Very soon, they will take gross form and come. We all are very spiritual people, fundamentally, you see. We know how the subtle manifests itself into the gross. At the time of wedding, Chunnu and Munnu are both the unmanifest. The great, unseen, invisible. Very soon, they will become manifest. They will take avatar. So you better have temples for them in advance. So two spare rooms are already there. It is a net. It doesn't matter which particular knot you get caught in. If you are caught in the entire net. Those who avoid, therefore avoid totally. You cannot be partially caught. In fact, to be partially caught is a deeper hell. If you are caught, you better be fully caught. Either you are out or you are totally in. You cannot have the tendency to be caught, yet remain only partially caught. It will be a matter of time. Complete bondage and total slavery will be your lot. Do not try to be free of particular objects. If you want freedom, be free of the tendency to not to be free. Trying for freedom from certain objects is like trying to ward off infections when your real problem is lack of immunity. How many pathogens, how many bacteria and viruses would you keep away? Sooner than later, someday, something, someone will penetrate. Your defenses are not that foolproof. If you don't have immunity, even one incident of a pathogen will be enough to take you to death. So when your problem is lack of immunity, do not fight outwards. Take care of the inside. Drop the lack of immunity. Drop the fear of freedom. Drop the attraction towards slavery.